Hello and welcome to this presentation on getting started with network segmentation using Red Hat Advanced Cluster Security. I'm Chris Porter. I'm a Senior Principal Solution Architect with Red Hat. Today, we're going to be introducing the concept of network segmentation and understanding how OpenShift uses Kubernetes network policies to provide the basis for network segmentation. We're going to use the Advanced Cluster Security Network Graph to understand and implement network policies. We're also going to use the ACS RockCTL command line tool to generate network policy generation from our applications. We're also going to look finally at the policy engine in ACS and some of the network policy related system policies and some best practices around those features. To start off, let's talk a little bit about network segmentation. In OpenShift, the platform itself provides the networking to allow running pods to communicate with the other pods in the cluster or with outside destinations. Within the container networking, OpenShift provides the Kubernetes network policy enforcements that can restrict pod communications. Now, building these network policy objects are the responsibility of the application teams, the developers and operations folks, but it's often security teams that'll dictate the requirement that these network policies be implemented. Pod-to-pod communication within a cluster is unlimited. It's wide open by default. There are no network policies that restrict this traffic. And then ultimately, network segmentation is the use of these network policies to restrict pod-to-pod communication. We want to limit our pods to the required flows for their operation and deny all other flows. This is what a network policy object in Kubernetes looks like. It has an object type of network policy, and we have to give it a name. The ingress specification in this example tells us that we want to allow connections coming from an app called checkout service on particular ports and protocols. And the policy is going to apply to an app called payment service. Network policies can restrict ingress or egress or both, but they're additive. So multiple policies will apply the rules in an additive way, and they're deny all by default. In other words, if I don't specify a particular port and protocol and a source matching rule, then I'll be denying all of those connections by default. Why do I want a network segment in the first place? Well, part of this is just good security practice. We want to isolate applications from each other to meet the principle of least privilege, that applications running in the cluster should only have as much access as they need to get their job done and nothing else. It might also play into zero trust networking goals. Zero trust is a set of principles that means, again, we don't trust anyone based on presence in the network or based on any previous association. We do it based entirely on a need to access rule set. We may want to control applications that handle sensitive data. Just because sensitive data is potentially disruptive, we might need to meet regulatory or industry compliance standards, or the disclosure of this would be disruptive, could result in fines and reputational loss for organizations that handle sensitive data. And then lastly, just the general principle of defense in depth. Segmenting the network will prevent an attacker who might gain a foothold elsewhere from moving laterally to these other application pods. Think of a front-end pod handling an application that allows an attacker to get in and then move to a database that contains sensitive information. If we choose a defense-in-depth approach, we'll prevent attackers who gain that foothold from getting any further and from exfiltrating data in the environment. Advanced Cluster Security provides us with a number of features to help us with the job of building good network segmentation policies. We're going to use here in the examples, we'll use the network graph user interface to examine actual network flows between deployment pods. So ACS will examine applications as they're running, look at the connections that they're initiating or are receiving, and show that visual relationship on the screen. We're then going to use the generate network policies feature of that network graph to create suggested network policies that will allow that observed traffic, but deny other traffic by default. Lastly, we'll jump into command line. We'll take a look at the ACS command line tool called RockCTL. We'll put this in a CI/CD pipeline, and we'll generate network policies directly from application deployment YAML files. Let's see how we can use the ACS GUI to understand and improve our network segmentation situation. From the network graph on the main menu here on the left, I'm going to choose my only cluster. If you have more than one cluster, you'll see a choice there. And then I can choose one or more namespaces. I'm going to start with a single namespace here. This is a good way to get started, would be to think about the network segmentation within a single application. In the graph here, if I click on the namespace background, you'll see all of the flows within that namespace for the period of time shown here. I can change the time frame. I can move things around and make it render a little bit more clearly. I can also click on an individual service or deployment to understand the network flows viewed in that time. On the right-hand side, I'll bring up some details about this. The important thing to look at here is the little red X shield. In fact, that's on the legend here as well, to show us that our traffic is all allowed, meaning that we don't have any network policies. It means that while we've only seen this set of flows over the last day, that actually any flow is available in and out of the cluster or from other pods and other namespaces. So what should we do about that? Well, obviously we want to create some network policies. How does ACS help us do that? The primary feature here that we're going to use is the network policy generator. And we can do this globally. We can use all the network policies from all the traffic observed, or we can filter this down to specific clusters and specific deployments, and then use the generate and simulate network policies button here to give me a list of network policies. These network policies use the observed flows from the past period of time, in this case 24 hours, and then creates rules that allow those flows, but denying all by default. Network policies that call out specific source pods, destination pods, and provide an ingress spec mean that all other ingress is denied by default. Now, I can take these and I can apply these directly into my environment by applying this as an object. These are Kubernetes network policies. So I can go ahead and apply these directly to an OpenShift cluster, and then we can observe the result in our network graph. Now I've gone ahead and applied the suggested network policies to this namespace by using the OpenShift command line or OpenShift console. And you can see that the icon has changed here. Now it shows that I have successfully filtered my ingress network policy. The same flows are observed because we've allowed those in our network policy, but everything else is going to be denied by default. Okay, so we've seen how you can use the ACS network graph to understand existing flows between components of an application and to generate network policies to segment our applications from each other without causing any disruption of that known traffic. Now, how would we use that in a large scale? Well, you can use the ACS GUI, of course, and use the network policy generator, and then copy and paste those network policies out into a source code repository or directly into the OpenShift cluster. But that doesn't really serve a purpose for developer workflow. We wanted to think about shifting left. We want to be able to do this earlier. We want to be able to understand the network connectivity that's needed between our applications without having to wait until that application is running. So the next step here is to show you how to use the same network policy generation, but in a command line using RockCTL, where I can embed this capability in a pipeline or just use it at my workstation to generate YAML. The magic here happens with RockCTL ingesting the YAML for an entire application. All of the services, every single deployment, service, config map, everything for an entire application that's going to communicate with each other, either in a folder, on disk, or merged in a single file. We're going to use the data that we find in there. RockCTL is going to examine environment variables. It's going to look at the ports on services, entries in config maps, and it's going to build a virtual connectivity map from these hints. That virtual connectivity map then we can use to generate network policies, or we can use it to do things like create a graph viz format diagram. We can even use this capability against two different sets of application definitions to understand the difference between network policy. As things change, as your applications evolve, we can understand what the needs are changing for network flows that network policies can accommodate. Let's take a look. Okay, so let's take a look at the RockCTL command line commands that we have here. In my directory here, I've got a typical application definition where I have a set of Kubernetes manifests. I have a set of image definitions in here, built those images, pushed them to a registry, and these Kubernetes manifests are going to refer to those images. But we're really interested in things like services and config maps and other definitions. So what we've done is gone ahead and basically compiled those into a single application file so that we don't have to go and providing a whole file or folder here. We can just do this from a single source file here. The RockCTL netpol generate takes either one, either a single file or a whole folder of that. And what we're going to do is use the RockCTL netpol generate, and this is going to take a single argument, just the source of the data that we're going to use, and it's going to prove by default, it's going to provide for us a set of network policies. Now, the difference from the network policy generator that you're going to find is that it handles both ingress and egress, getting us closer to our goal of network policy segmentation. It's going to provide it for all of the application components that it finds in there. It's also going to provide some provision for standard network traffic like port 53 UDP for services like DNS. Again, I can write these to a file. I can create a folder here where I want to supply the output of this. Really, this should be part of my my application code. Really should be part of the Git repo that I have that. Another thing that I can do is use RockCTL netpol connectivity. And there's a couple of options within here, either a diff to be able to do the difference between two different versions of my application, as well as creating a map. And to do the map here, again, I can just supply that single argument of a file, and it's going to produce an output here in a format called graphviz. This is a dot file, and I can use that to either render directly, or I can use utilities to convert this into something like a visual representation, like an SVG, a scalable vector graphics format. Okay, so how do we use all of the features that we've seen in ACS to create a strategy for building and maintaining the network segmentation rules for our applications out there? First, you should be aware there's a system policy called deployments should have at least one ingress network policy that comes default with ACS, but it is disabled by default. And obviously, you're going to want to clone that and enable this policy for visibility or enable the default one. Although I'd recommend cloning the default system policy and changing the scope of your clone so that the clone version here is targeted for specific applications. Carve off one application at a time, maybe a mission-critical application in your environment. With that, we'll get visibility into violations. In other words, we'll find out where deployments don't have any ingress network policy defined. In order to meet the requirement raised by this policy about defining these, we can provide teams with access to RockCTL or to the ACS user interface to use the network graph. If we approach it through the RockCTL, the binary itself can be downloaded from the ACS UI. You can get it publicly from mirror.openshift.com, or there's a containerized version of RockCTL that you can pull from the same sources that you'd get the ACS software from. You can also use RockCTL netpol generate without an API token. This makes it different than other RockCTL features that require access to and authentication with Central. In this case, the logic is built all entirely within RockCTL. Let's take a look at how system policies should be used for our strategy for network segmentation. Okay, let's take a look at the ACS GUI and configure policy to support our network segmentation goals. I'm going to navigate down to Policy Management under the Platform Configuration menu and scroll down to find a default policy called Deployments Should Have At Least One Ingress Network Policy. Now, you notice this is disabled, and I could use the three-button menu on the right here to simply enable that, but that would be enabled globally, and I don't want to boil the ocean today. What I want to do is start with a tightly scoped policy that will focus on my application. So I'm going to clone this policy, give it a name. Since we're going to focus on that boutique application that we were looking at earlier, I'm going to focus on that. I'm not going to change the policy behavior or the criteria here. They're going to stay the same. I am going to make sure that this policy is enabled. And then once we save it, it'll be available for just that namespace. So the policy scope, I can delete all of these exclusions here. There's a whole bunch of them added from the original default policy here that I don't need. And I'm going to add an inclusion scope for, of course, for the boutique namespace. And then when I save this, I'm going to get, before I save it, I'm going to get some deployment preview here of the policy violations that are currently active once I save this. Now I go back to my policy management list. I do need to enable that. The cloning keeps the policy disabled by default. And as soon as I enable that, then the ACS system will go back and start to reassess all the deployments there. If I want to force it, there's a reassess all button here. Shouldn't be necessary in this case, but it's worth a click. What I should see is a list of the violations, and I can filter on a particular namespace, but you can see here they're at the top of my list that all of these particular entities have the missing network policy here. You can see the description. I can optionally tie this policy to a notification to send folks information about this. I can send it out to external systems through webhooks or other notification integrations, but we'll also view that data here. In order to resolve this, I would go back to the beginning of the lesson here and use the network graph or RockCTL to create appropriate ingress network policies for my application.